Hello everybody, Jesper Grip here for Creativo.com and CreativeStation.net. Today I will bring you a tutorial made by Sergey Likachev, or as most of you know him, as Batkia. This is the English version of the tutorial and it's also available in Russian. So let's get right into it. Open your city image in Photoshop, add a layer mask to your layer. Then with the selection tool, like the last tool for example, select unwanted pieces of the sky, and then control backspace to fill it with your foreground color. It must be black, so if you don't have black selected, you can press X to switch color. This image is an image that is cropped, so to fix that we need to cut out our buildings to make sure they get the right look. Just use the same lasso tool and mask out the parts of the top of the buildings. With the lasso tool, select a piece of a building and copy it into a new layer, Ctrl-J. Then transform it using Ctrl-T and do this around 3 times for a good start. Then merge them together with Ctrl E. Also use your clone stamp here to just remove those glares in the window. Now what you want to do is just take your tool and just mask out a piece of what you just created and mask it out basically so the building behind comes out again and you can actually see that. Now after you fix your building up a little bit, just take your clone stamp and then build up the building again so you get it the perfect square that you want to. Now we need to make the sides of the building to give the image perspective. To do so, copy a part of the image and flip it horizontally. Then transform your image some to make sure it fits the perspective, and then delete any not needed parts. On a new layer, select the part where the two images meet and make a small square. Then fill it with a gray color to make an edge. Then use your clone stamp to change the reflection sum on your newly created side so no one can tell it's a copy. It's really important to work hard on reflection because it will really help your image look better. Now we need to make this building a bit higher. Select a part of it. Remember to make the top of the thing correct when you cut it out, because it will be the one you will use in the end. Now use the transform tool to align the top correctly. Now, as you can see, the top and the bottom part differs a little bit in colors, and therefore we will use levels to even that out. Also, make sure to modify the wall we did before slightly. Now, to make sure that we have a nice and tidy workplace, we're going to merge all the images together in a group. Just select them and press Ctrl J. And then name it whatever you want, preferably environment. Now we're going to insert a photograph of the mountains and the sky. Make sure to add a layer mask to them. Insert the sky image in multiply, and then we're just going to lighten it up a little bit by using the adjustment layer levels. Because the mountains is closer to us, they need to be darker. Select as much of the sky as you can, and then brush on the layer mask with varying opacity, thus creating aerial perspective. This is a job that takes quite some time, but it really pays off if you take the time and make sure the mountain gets all the attention they need. We import another image with the mountain. Using a layer mask, remove a necessary part of it that we do not want, and that would be the sky and the branches. In the original image we had of the city, it had a blue sky, and now there are mountains. The sky was blue and bright, and therefore we need to make the buildings darker and match the new sky we have. The best way to do so is using selective color adjustment layer to change the colors, and then we need to adjust the entire image with a curve to make it more contrast. The sky now have a yellowish tint, and the source file had more of a blue tint. So create a layer blending mode set to color, and brush opacity about 50, and paint the color of the new sky on the buildings to give them an orange tint. insert the rocks, and using a layer mask, we remove unwanted parts of the image. In this case, a piece of the rock and the sky. Let's create the appearance that we have a building built in the rock, partly rising from the rock. Working with the lasso tool here is a great way of making the rock more realistic and just not look like it's melted on the sides. When we want to create this illusion of the building in the rock, we also need to change the side of the building so we see the stone reflected in it. Remember those reflections, they are always important. Now we want to remove some of the rock, so our building inside of the rock have some entrances and stuff. Layer masks are great here because you can always go back and change if you aren't satisfied. Brush with varying degrees of opacity on our mask. Try to create a smooth transition from water on the original image into our photo with the rocks. Like always, take your time here to get the image just right, and remember to always think about how it would work in the real world, so you do not get stuck with something that looks weird. Now create a new layer and use the lasso to draw between the buildings. We want a piece of rock here as well, so it really looks like our building is inside of the rock. But since we don't have any rock that we can use here, we're just going to use the lasso tool and draw out a piece of the rock like you want it, and then just use the clone stamp to copy the rock from the other side, and then just make it like we want it to look like. Now just insert another mountain image to the left and then just remove any necessary parts like before, just using the normal brush and the layer mask. Use the lasso tool to make the mountain look more natural at the top, as well as down below the buildings. Correct the image colors and make it lighter, to merge better with the environment. Make first a new layer that you fill with gray and set it to color. Then use brightness and contrast, as well as levels, to achieve a good result of your color correction. All the adjustment layers we use are done with a clipping mask, so they only affect the layer we want them to, and not the whole image. Also, just make sure to fix your mask off the rocks a little bit to ensure they look better. Just insert another image of your rocks as a clipping mask. The new image will fall exactly on the previous one, and then just fix your mask a little bit again so it fits the building better. Then make a mask on your new image that you just imported into Photoshop. And with a big soft brush, remove the edges of the image to let the brighter one shine through. And then also lighten your new rock image up a little bit so it's not too dark. Use levels for this. Finished building the portion of the water to your right, which aren't currently there, just use the clone stamp and have the tool set to all layers in the mode. This will draw images from all layers and not just one, and then you will get a really smooth transition, including the rock water glare as well. Once again, I cannot stress enough that you should take your time here to just make sure to get this right, because if you do not do that, the image won't look good. Now insert an image of a waterfall. The waterfall will be located between two buildings. Move any unwanted parts of the image. Make sure to fit the waterfall so it fits perfectly between your two buildings. Because the waterfall is located way behind your bridge, you want to make sure the bridge is visible. It's important because the water wouldn't be on top of the bridge if it's far behind it. Use a brush with a little opacity and fix the edges of your waterfall, allowing the cloud of water to still be there even though it's behind the bridge. correct the colors of your waterfall using the hue saturation. Do it a little bit less saturated so it matches your image better. And also fix your waterfall so it looks better and do not flow where it wouldn't fall naturally. Now we want to change the building closest to the water, and we have a building with a green vine growing on it, and it really fits the image good, so we're going to import that. And just delete the parts that you do not need as usual, and make sure it fits to the old building, so it doesn't get too big or whatever. Also make sure to don't forget about those trees, because they are really good at looking in the image, and you really want those trees to make the image look better. And now when we added in the new building here, it has to be a little bit shaded, because it actually is in the shades. So add an adjustment layer, levels as always, with a clipping mask, and just darken it down a little bit. Okay, so now we add in an image of buildings along a riverbed, but we don't really want anything else but the platform the buildings is standing on, so just remove the rest except for the platform it's on. Just adjust the colors and brightness of your foundation so this fits the rest of the image. Hue saturation is great for this. Now to create a reflection in the water, duplicate the layer, flip it vertically, and then with the transformation tool, we distort it to fit the image. Reduce the opacity of it, and then add a layer mask. Then just use a normal brush, and just smooth the edges out to give it a more of a merged in effect. We now just fix a pillar under our building so it has something to stand on. on the left side of the image, we want to add in yet another rock. And as always, remove unwanted things with just using the normal layer mask. Here we use the color range to get rid of the sky, because Bakian probably thought it was an easier way this time. Just take your time though, and make sure you give the expression of the rock actually being behind the building, and not just lying on top of it. This image is too sharp when we look at it, so apply some Gaussian blur to it to make it even out. To do this in a good way, you also need to paint in some gray areas to allow for highlights. Then also apply some levels to it to match the aerial perspective. Now we want some more green in our image, so import an image with trees, then remove everything but the trees. When we imported our normal trees, we just want one tree as well in the center of the city. So what we do then is just copy the tree layer you just had, and then just remove everything except for one big tree. Now we need to add some light and shadows to the trees closest to our waterfront. The light will fall from the middle of the city to the lower left corner. So create an adjustment layer, brightness and contrast, fill the whole mask black, and paint with your brush where you want the light to hit. The tree we have in the city, we just brighten with normal levels. Now we will work on the shadows of the city. Add a curve and set it to multiply, and then add a mask and invert it, Control I. You can also just fill it with black, but it's faster to just Control I. Then take a soft brush with low opacity and work the places you want shadows to appear. Remember to have a fixed light source, so there isn't light coming from everywhere, since that wouldn't look good at all. Here we just take some little extra time to just fix up the rocks at the top and make sure they look perfect for the final image. At this point, most of the work is finished. Now we just need to make the most important work, and that is the color correction. What you want to do is then just take a color balance and then just change the shadows, midtones, and highlights in the way you see Batikian doing here. And then with the shortcut keys, Control Alt Shift and E, you merge all the images onto a new layer. And then, like Batikian is doing here, we use Vivesa Nick software. It's a plugin, and it will allow for a really clean contrast. But you can always use a normal adjustment layer as well. It's just that, yeah, we prefer this one for faster workflow. We also wanted to add a little HDR effect, and therefore we used the plugin Topaz Labs to make this effect. Just choose a present HDR color, and then moving the sliders, we create the desired effect. The HDR effect is a little bit too strong, so therefore we lowered the opacity down a bit and also mask out areas like the sky and such, so the HDR isn't included there. If anyone is interested in how to make an HDR effect without using Topaz Labs, just comment below and I'll make sure to make a tutorial if it is interested for you guys. And that is it for this tutorial, guys. Thank you for watching and remember to subscribe to both Creative Station and Creativo.com, and we will create these tutorials for you as much as we can. So thank you for watching and remember to also sub to Batkian. This was a great tutorial made by him. Thank you and have a great day.